Hi everyone, welcome to another episode of OEM TV. I'm Eric Mills with Microsoft. I do Windows Server Marketing here. And in this video, you're going to see a demo of the Essentials Intune integration. And when I say Essentials, I mean the Windows Server Essentials Edition with Intune. In the video, Ken will take you step by step through setting it up. He'll talk about, you know, what is Intune. You know, essentially, it's a way to manage all your mobile devices, your mobile apps, manage your compliance. A lot of people are very interested in how this works. So in the video, you'll see what it looks like. Ken will talk about why use it. He'll talk about the integration between Office 365 and EMS, the Enterprise Mobility Suite. He'll walk you through the wizard to enable the integration with Windows Server Essentials Edition, give you a quick demo of the Intune portal where you will see the dashboard, the groups, the alerts, the reports, and the administrative section. So hopefully you enjoy this video. If you're interested in Intune and you're considering using Windows Server Essentials, you're definitely going to want to check this out, see the integration between the two, and hope you enjoy the video. We'll see you next time on OEM TV.
This video focuses on demonstrating the integration of Windows Server 2016 Essentials with Microsoft Intune. For this demonstration, we are running Windows Server 2016 Essentials Edition in a virtual machine running on a local server. You also have the option of running Windows Server 2016 Essentials natively on a local server. For Windows Server Essentials integration with Microsoft Intune, a Microsoft Azure and Office 365 30-day trial or full subscription is also required. Now, Intune is a cloud-based enterprise mobility management service that helps enable your workforce to be productive while keeping your corporate data protected. With Intune, you can manage the mobile devices your workforce uses to access company data, manage the mobile apps your workforce uses, protect your company information by helping to control the way your workforce accesses and shares it, and ensure devices and apps are compliant with company security and requirements. Intune integrates closely with Azure Active Directory for identity and access control, and Azure Information Protection for data protection. Together, Office 365 and Enterprise Mobility Suite, or EMS, enable your workforce to be productive on all of their devices while keeping your organization's information protected. Office 365 with EMS is a complete integrated suite for enterprise mobility inclusive of productivity, identity access control, management, and data protection. It gives you an effective way to deploy and operate a mobility solution in your organization. To begin, I will enable the integration with Microsoft Intune via a wizard in the Windows Server Essentials dashboard. The Server Essentials dashboard is part of the Windows Server 2016 Essentials Edition and is automatically installed as part of the Windows installation and accessible via a shortcut on the desktop. Now let's go ahead and enable the integration with a full subscription of Microsoft Office 365, Azure, and Microsoft Intune. So for within the Windows Server Essentials dashboard, I'm going to come over here on the left-hand side and select Services. Then in the middle, we're going to select Intune. And then over here on the right-hand side, we're going to click on Integrate with Microsoft Intune. We will now walk through the wizard here to enable the integration. And as I mentioned, Microsoft Intune provides a unified infrastructure to manage computers and multiple types of mobile devices through cloud services or by extending your existing on-premises infrastructure. So let's go ahead and click Configure, and that's it. We'll go ahead and click Close, and that is very simple. But you'll notice that completing this step really hasn't done anything. The only thing changed in the dashboard is showing Intune has been enabled. At this time, there are no new plugins, features, or options exposed for managing users or mobile devices. So let's keep digging in a bit. It turns out that the really only option from the integration services area of the dashboard is to go to the online portal to manage Intune from there. But before we go to the online Intune portal, let's take a look at activating the Intune licenses for each user. You do have the option of activating the Intune licenses from either the Windows Server Essentials dashboard or from the Intune portal. Now, within the Windows Server Essentials dashboard, let's click over here on Users, and then we're going to double-click on one of the users to be able to see the different properties. So we'll double-click on Test User 1. And from there, we're going to go to the Microsoft Cloud tab, and we can see all the different licenses that this user currently has access to. And we notice we see Microsoft Intune down below here. We're going to go ahead and select that to give that user access to the Microsoft Intune and be able to manage their mobile devices as well as other types of laptops and other devices as well. We'll go over here and click Apply. And here we have enabled Microsoft Intune for this particular user. Now again, at this time, there are no more Intune features or functions exposed through the dashboard. We can only assign licenses from here. To start actually using Intune, we have to manage everything from the portal. So let's take a look at the features available through the Microsoft Intune portal. Now here we are at the Microsoft Intune portal through my browser. On the left-hand side, you can see the different features we can configure, from groups, to alerts, to apps, the policies, look at some reports, and then do the administration of Microsoft Intune and your devices. From the opening dashboard, you can learn all about the things you can do with Intune, from managing your mobile devices, managing computers, getting started, and other important information, and we'll go through some of those in a little bit. So let's take a look at managing mobile devices. So now under getting started with managing mobile devices, you can set up and deploy your mobile device security and see all the device types that are supported with Microsoft Intune. So up at the top here is where you can deploy a mobile device security policy. And then in the middle here, you can see the available mobile platforms like Windows, Windows Phone, iOS and macOS, Android, and even Microsoft Exchange. Let's go back to the dashboard. And now let's take a look at managing computers. Under getting started with managing computers, you can create and deploy policies on all your organization computers. And then you can also set up to download and deploy the Intune client so you can manage and deploy different software to all your clients. Let's go back to the dashboard. And here on the right, each of these items directs you to more detailed information and step-by-step instructions for getting started. You can see which devices and browsers are supported and prerequisites for managing your devices. Now let's take a look at each of the features here on the left side, starting with groups. Click on groups. With groups, we can create a new group on existing users or devices. You can also see other information here on the health of your devices, apps installed on the devices, some of the device alerts, the policies that are installed on there as well. And then over here on the right-hand side under task is where you can either add users or go ahead and create a group, again, based on existing users or devices. Now let's go over here on the left and click on alerts. And here under alerts, we can see the list of all alerts you can set for users, devices, and services within your organization. And you can use different templates and so forth associated with the different alerts, enable them, disable them, set the different type of severity level here as well. Now let's go ahead and click on apps. Now under apps is where you can see which apps have been installed and deployed on any or all of your devices, and also configure specific apps to install and deploy to devices throughout your organization. Now let's go over here and select policy. Under policy is where you can configure and deploy configuration, compliance, and conditional access policies across your organization. If I go over here and click on add policy, we can choose from a list of existing templates for the devices you want to create a policy for. Here you can see all the supported devices with Microsoft Intune, from Android to iOS to macOS to Windows, and even the different software that you want to set a policy for and what can be installed and what is accessible and what is valid and so forth. Let's go ahead and cancel that. And now let's take a look at the reports section. Now under reports, we can see the category list of predefined reports you can run. You can see detected software reports where you can view all software installed on the computers you manage. You can look at mobile device inventory reports for the information about all your mobile devices that you manage. And then there's other ones like around terms and condition reports, viewing the health reports. Over here on the right, you see non-compliant app reports, certificate compliance reports, and even device history reports. And the last tab over here on the left, admin, this section is where you administer all the features and services for Intune, including alerts, administration, management, mobile device management, and third-party service connectors. So here we've just done a quick walkthrough of the Microsoft Intune portal and show how you can manage all your devices, your computers, and different groups and policies and so forth. Okay, thank you.